Hello, namaste, konnichiwa, welcome from Sunny Sensei. In this video, we will solve some problems on fixed price incentive fee contracts. Our first question is on the screen. A fixed price incentive fee contract has a target cost of $150,000, a target profit of $20,000, a ceiling price of $180,000, and a share ratio of 60 to 40. The actual cost of the project is $160,000. How much profit will the seller make? It is always best to start with the cost variance. Remember, the cost variance tells us how much the actual cost differs from the target cost. Mathematically, cost variance, or CV, is simply target cost minus the actual cost. Our target cost is $150,000. And the actual cost is $160,000. So, the cost variance is minus $10,000. Minus is definitely not good. It indicates a cost overrun. The seller has spent more than the target. How will this impact the seller? The second term in the share ratio is 40%. This means 40% of the cost variance is seller's responsibility. Seller's share of risk, in our example, is 40% of minus 10,000 or minus $4,000. Next, let's look at the actual price, which is actual cost plus target profit. We could have stopped here if the seller had managed to keep the actual cost exactly equal to the target cost. But in this example, we have a cost variance. Cost variance is not zero. We have to adjust the target profit by seller's share of risk for the cost variation. Actual cost is $160,000. Target profit is $20,000. Which is adjusted by minus 4,000. Profit has been reduced by 4,000. 160,000 plus 16,000 or 176,000. We have to compare this with the ceiling price. 176 is less than 180. We are definitely to the left of the PTA. Point of total assumption from my introductory video on FPIF contracts. 176,000 is our actual price. Actual profit is simply actual price minus actual cost. That is $16,000. With this, we have solved the problem. Still, for better understanding of FPIF contracts, let's compare the actual price and profit to the target values. The seller got a profit of $16,000. Target profit was $20,000. Seller ends up with $4,000 less than that. Sum of target cost and target profit is target price. 150,000 plus 20,000 is 170,000, the target price. But the buyer has to pay 176,000. 6,000 higher. A loss to the buyer. Buyer lost 6,000 and the seller lost 4,000. Together, they lost $10,000, a value equal to the cost variance. 60% of the loss is on the buyer. And 40% is on the seller. This matches with the share ratio of 60 to 40. That's the way it should be, as the actual cost is lower than the PTA. We have solved this question purely with our understanding of the FPIF concepts. Let's try solving the same question using the formulas that we discussed in an earlier video. These are the two formulas for the actual price. Each one of these compares the calculated value with the ceiling price. the minimum of calculated value and the selling price is the actual price. Let's try the first formula. Actual cost is 160,000. Target profit is 20,000. Cost variance is target cost minus actual cost. It is 150,000 minus 160,000. Seller's share of risk in percent is 40%. Calculating further, we get 176,000. Selling price is 180,000. 176,000 is smaller than the selling price. So, 176,000 is the actual price. Next, we will try the second formula. Actual cost is 160,000. Target cost is 150,000. Buyer share of risk in percent is 60%. Target price is simply sum of target cost and target profit. That is 150,000 plus 20,000. We solve this further. And we get $176,000. This is smaller than the ceiling price of 180,000. And thus, actual price is 176,000. We have the same answer with each of the two formulas. These are equivalent formulas and will always give us the same result. The result also matches to what we got with our earlier conceptual approach. Either approach is fine. Pick the one that suits your style. This is the next problem on FPIF contracts. Target cost, target profit, selling price, share ratio, and actual cost are given. We have to find the actual profit, actual price, and the PTA, or the point of total assumption. We will start with actual price. Actual price is actual cost plus target profit adjusted for the seller's share of risk. Actual cost is $150,000. Target profit is 15,000. A risk adjustment is simply cost variance multiplied by seller share of risk in percent. Cost variance is 130,000 minus 150,000. Seller share of risk in percent is 20%. This is the second term in share ratio. Calculating further, we get 161,000. This is definitely more than the selling price. So, our actual price equals the selling price or $160,000. The actual cost has gone beyond the PTA. Next, let's look at the actual profit. It is actual price minus the actual cost or 160,000 minus 150,000. We get $10,000 as the actual profit. We have worked out the actual price and the actual profit. Next, let's calculate the PTA. Just to refresh our memories, this is how a plot of actual price against actual cost looks like. When actual cost equals PTA, or we can say at the PTA, the calculated value of the actual price will be equal to the selling price. Actual price equals actual cost plus target profit plus seller's share of risk. Seller's share of risk is the incentive associated with the cost variance. It will be cost variance or target cost minus actual cost multiplied by seller share of risk in percent. This equation is true at the PTA, so we can replace the actual cost with the PTA. And including the known values in the equation, we get and we have 148,750 as the PTA. At this value of actual cost and beyond, the actual price is always equal to the selling price. We are done with the question. Still, let's dig a little deeper to improve our understanding of FPIF contracts. Our target cost is $130,000. The actual cost is $150,000. Cost variance is minus 20,000. The cost variance can be split into two. Minus 18,750 between target cost and PTA, and minus 1,250 between PTA and actual cost. For the portion till the PTA, seller has to bear 20% of the burden. This is as per the given share ratio. Minus 3,750 is the number. Above the PTA, seller takes 100% of the burden. The FPIF contract behaves like firm fixed price contract here. So, minus 1,250 is for the seller. Total hit to the seller is minus $5,000. Target profit was $15,000 but gets reduced by $5,000 to give the actual profit of just $10,000. This is same as what we calculated earlier. With this, we come to the end of this lesson. I hope it was useful. Please share your thoughts and questions in the comment section below. All the best from Sunny Sensei.